A Carroll County teenager is really working hard at practicing the skills that he learned on NBC's The Biggest Loser, and you probably remember him.
Yeah, in tonight's Healthier Youth Report, Jennifer Franciani checks back in with an eighth grader by the name of Bingo, who said he just wanted to be able to be a normal kid.
Kicking the ball around with his mom without getting out of breath is something eighth grader Noah Gray couldn't do just a few months ago. But that was all before the 13-year-old from New Windsor went on NBC's The Biggest Loser.
It was just crazy, totally different, and very exciting and fun.
When we first caught up with Noah back in January, he liked to be called Bingo then. But now, not only has he shed his nickname, he's also dropped 50 pounds using lessons he learned on the show about making better food choices.
Most of it's nutrition. Being able to eat healthy is a lot of it. And then exercise is like another good 20% of it. So it's a lot, and you just have to really be able to have your mindset to do it and work at it.
This was the first Biggest Loser season to focus on childhood obesity. And Noah says figuring out what caused him to gain weight in the first place was really important. He blames it on stress eating from moving to a new home.
Now I've learned not to eat my emotions, and it's definitely a lot better.
And he feels a whole lot better about himself. Noah's back to playing baseball, something he did before gaining weight, and he's been a good influence, too, on his mom, dad, and sister. They've dropped over 200 pounds as a family.
We all are much healthier for it and feel so much better.
And for other children struggling like Noah used to, he has some advice.
But if you really want it, you can do it, and it's not a big deal if you really want it, and you can really just do it.
Noah is now at his goal weight. He's able to maintain it. His family, by the way, still losing weight, and they were all looking forward to fun spring and summer activities. In Baltimore, Jennifer Franciati, WBAL-TV 11 News.